how to write the results section of your research paper. Hello and welcome. My name is Anthony P, and I give lectures and seminars to the top universities in Asia on academic writing and publishing. With my team of over 100 academic English experts, we have created free content such as this to help you write your research paper and get your research published. In this video, we will discuss what to include in a results section, how to use figures in a results section, and we will discuss the 6 steps on how to write your results section. All right, let's get stuck in. How to write the results section of your academic research paper for thesis, dissertation, journal paper, conference paper, essay, and research report. What is the results section and what does the results section do? The results section of a scientific research paper represents the core findings of a study. It presents these findings in a logical sequence without bias or interpretation from the author. The results section breaks your data into sentences, directly linking them to your research question. What is included in a results section? The results section should describe the findings of your study. The results section does not need much else. The findings include data presented in tables, charts, graphs, and figures, data analysis, data corresponding to the research questions, and secondary findings. If you have a lot of data, only state the most relevant data to your research question. What is not included in the results section? To keep the results section clear for readers, avoid including these. Avoid including explanations and interpretations of the data. And avoid including secondary results that do not contribute to answering the research question. Next section, how to organize your findings. Here are some organization tips to help you clearly present your findings. Restate one of your research questions, then present the data that addresses that research question. Do this for all of your research questions. You can group similar data together. For example, start with the positive results, then the neutral results, then the negative results. You can group data into chronological order. For example, start with data from the 1980s, then the 90s, then the 2000s. Presenting your findings in one of these ways will help your reader follow your narrative. How to use charts in your results section. When you decide to include a chart or graph to illustrate data, create them with your research question in mind. Let's do an example. Take this research question. How do newly developed teaching methods impact average test scores in a 5th grade classroom? Now, let's turn this question into an easy-to-interpret graph. This figure is captioned, Average Test Score Change in a 5th Grade Classroom After 2 Weeks of Teacher-Led Review. Can you see how this directly answers the research question? Taking a look at the structure of this chart, we can clearly see labeled X and Y axes. The chart is easy for the reader to interpret, and easy for the reader to compare the different methods to each other and to the control group. Your data will likely look more complex than this simple example. However, the design principles you learned here can be applied to your data and figures. Next section, captioning and referencing tables and figures. Captioning your tables helps readers understand the data you are presenting. Remember that while your findings clarify and enhance the text, they cannot replace it. Now, time for some useful tips. Follow these tips to nail your paper structure and readability. It is vital that you consult the standards and requirements for captioning and referencing. Consult the standards of the particular journal to which you will be submitting your paper. Standards and formatting may vary greatly from one journal to another, so you may have a few variations of the same paper if you are submitting to multiple journals. Use previously published papers by your target journal or Microsoft Word templates for reference and inspiration. Every figure you place in the results section must be referenced in the text. Place your figures in order that they are referenced. Need some more resources? The University English Hub has you covered. We have already made a video just for you on journal instructions for authors that you can visit in the description below. Now, how can you write about your results in your paper? The first step is to give the basic information about how the study went. For example, in total, 60 students were enrolled in the study, with 15 per group. 3 students dropped out during the study for personal reasons. Here's a tip: be concise. Long sentences do not always help the reader understand complex ideas or data. For example, let's talk about our data in this chart. The students who practiced method 3 showed the greatest improvement with an average increase of 4.5% in their average test scores, figure 1. Methods 1 and 2 yielded smaller but similar increases in average test scores, and the change in scores in the control group was negligible. Also, in the text, write about the most interesting and important results. Don't mention every single one. This quickly gets boring for readers. If you are enjoying this free content and you want to support this channel, please take a moment to like and subscribe below. Thanks. On to our next topic, the 6 steps for writing a great results section. Step 1, read your target journal's guidelines for authors. Find the specific requirements for the results section in the instructions for authors. Note length limitations and restrictions. For example, some journals may combine results and discussion sections into one single section. Consider the aims and missions of the journal to best align your results with the journal's goals. Often, journals have a very specific goal in how they wish to present the research for their readership. And read some papers published by your target journal on a similar topic, or some papers that follow the same research design and writing format. By following that approach of previously published papers, you can feel confident that your approach meets the standards of your target journal. Step 2, outline your results section. This is similar to making a rough draft. You could organize results into chronological order. You could organize results into a hierarchy of importance. You could copy the order that the information is presented in the introduction. You could copy the order that information is presented in the methods. Step 3, design your charts. Number tables and figures in the order that they are presented. The data you present should be easy to interpret on their own without explanation. Use tables and figures as a way to enhance your narrative and guide your reader through your text. Step 4, draft your results section. Finally, you can start some serious writing. Restate your research questions in the opening of the results section. Summarize key findings at the end of the results section as a transition into your discussion section. Write in the past tense and active voice, as your research has already been done. Your goal is to convey complex data clearly and concisely. Remember, long sentences do not make your point more understandable. Ask yourself, could I have written this same sentence in fewer words? All right, step 5, edit and revise your results. The editing process will take a long time. Anticipate this and schedule it into your calendar. Editing and revision should not wait until the week before submission. Ask yourself, does your text report your results exactly? Double-check the accuracy and consistency of all data as well as your figures. Read your draft aloud to catch errors or awkward phrasing. Look back over your paper's introduction and methodology. Do you report your findings in a way that is consistent with your introduction and methodology? Does your paper flow well? And peer review. Ask your classmates, colleagues, and professors to read over your paper. Read their comments and be grateful for their feedback. This is a pillar of academic writing. Try to enjoy it. And finally, step 6, hire a professional editor. Have your paper edited professionally by a native speaker of English. Here at Uni-edit, we have a team of native English editors from the USA, UK, and Australia. We edit all kinds of academic texts in preparation for submission or publication. Using our service gives your paper the best chance to make a real impact by fixing language mistakes, making your language read more naturally, and by increasing the clarity of your ideas. To learn about our journal paper English editing service, you can visit the website in the description below. You can also hire me directly for one-on-one tutoring. For more information, you can visit the website in the description below. I'd love to work with you. That's all for today. Your results section is critical in reporting your findings to the world. Good luck in your writing process, and we hope to see you again here soon. Please like and subscribe if you have learned a lot from this free content. Good luck, and I'll see you again soon.